dear students and parents, I hope you all are fit and fine at your home. We have completed our 7 block and 2 lesson plans. Today we are going to start our 3rd lesson plan. I hope you all have completed your homework also. What did I give you in your homework? Yes, I have given you to choose 3 things from the garden and then write 2 describing words for each thing. Today again we are going to learn about the describing words. So what is our today's topic? Our today's topic is describing a thing. So for this topic, what will be our resources? First of all, you have to collect your resources. And the resources are paper sheets with words tree, toe, the, is, favorite, my. You have to prepare the paper sheets like this. These words should be written on the paper sheets. And content notebook and workbook you have to keep with you. And the keywords for this: naming words, describing words, full stop, and our agenda. As usual, first we'll go for the questioning, then activity, then discussion part, after then activity, and then homework. Yes, students, yesterday we have used many of the describing words for 2 trees. Yes, to find out the difference between 2 trees, we have used describing words through a word web. What will we do today? Today we will use the describing words in our sentences. Yes, by using the describing words we will make. Yes, student, look at this bottle. Yes, what is the color of this bottle? Right, the color of the bottle is blue. If you are saying blue man, so I'm always saying that you have to give your answer in complete sentence. So what will you say? You will say, ma'am, the color of the bottle is blue. So today, what is our aim? Today we are going to use the describing words in our sentences. Yes, students, so this is our aim, to use describing words to form sentences. Now it is time for the action part. Yes, student, tell me, what is the favorite thing of Pranav? Yes, what is the favorite thing of Pranav? Right, his favorite things were tree. Yes, and what is your favorite thing? Yes, it may vary. Yes, my favorite thing is mango. Yes, I like mango. So this is my favorite thing. So you can use some describing words for your favorite things. Yes, I like mango. It is very tasty. It is juicy. So what is this tasty and juicy? These are the describing words. So this how we will we are going to use the describing words in the sentences. So action part, we will do an activity. In this activity, I will show you some paper sheets as I told you in the beginning of the class. By using those paper sheets, you will make sentences. So let's move for the activity now. Yes, students, these are the paper sheets. Yes, by using these paper sheets, we will make sentences. Yes. What could be the sentence? Yes, the tall tree is my favorite. Yes, the tall tree is my favorite. Yes, the tall tree is my favorite. So this how I have made the sentences by using the describing words also. Yes, can you find out the describing words? Yes, this tall. How is the tree? Tall. So this one is the describing word. Yes, favorite. This is also the describing words. Yes, by using these words, we have made the sentence. I have more paper sheets. By using these paper sheets, I will make more sentences. Like, I am tall. I am tall. Yes, I am tall. Is this completed? Is this a complete sentence? Yes. Now it is completed. We have to put full stop after ending the sentence. When our sentence ends, we are putting a full stop at the end of the sentence. Now it is complete. Now again I'm making one more sentence. Circle is blue. Circle is blue. Yes, and we can make many sentences like this. Toy, my toy is black. Again, we have to put full stop here. Yes, we should use full stop. Yes, this how we can make the sentences by using the describing words.
Yes, students, how did you make these sentences? In the activity, we have used the paper chits. On the chits, some words were written. By using those words, you have made the sentences. Okay, how have you made those sentences? Yes, this how we have made the sentences. The door tree is by Fitbit. I am tall. Circle is blue. Yes, what is this tall? This tall is a describing word. This is also the describing word. This blue is also a describing word. First of all, we have taken one naming word. What is this tree here? Tree is a naming word. It is the name of the thing. Yes, we have taken one naming word. Then we have taken some describing word to describe the naming words. And after that, we have added some more word to form a sentence. Yes, students, we have used describing words in these sentences. Okay, where have we used these describing words? Yes, right. We are using these describing words either before the naming word or after am or is are. We are using it. Okay. या तो हम नेमिंग वर्ड से पहले डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड का यूज करते हैं और हम इज एम आर के बाद यूज करते हैं. सो दिस हाउ वी आर यूजिंग द डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स. यस स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन ट्राई टू मेक मोर सेंटेंसेस बाय यूजिंग द पेपर चिट्स. व्हाट विल यू डू? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू विल सॉर्ट आउट द नेमिंग वर्ड्स, देन यू विल यूज द डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स दैट विल मोस्टली मैच विद द match with your naming word, and after that you will use ismr also to form the complete sentence, and at the end of the sentence you will must use full stop. This how you will make the sentences. Yes students, after the activity we are moving to the analysis part. Now I'm going to ask the questions which are based on the activity. Yes students, my first question is, which sentences did you make? Yes, you have made, I think so, you have made many of the sentences, and I have made The tall tree is my favorite, like I am a tall boy. This how you have made the sentences. Yes, my next question is, how did you make sentences with the words which you got? How did you make sentences with the words which you got? Yes, what did you do first of all, students? Yes, first of all you have chosen some of the naming words. After that you have chosen the describing words which can describe the describe most your naming words, and after that we have used some words like is and are to connect the sentence, and at the end we have used full stop also, and doing words also we have used. This how we have completed the sentence. Like this, we have, first of all we have taken the word Pranav. What is this Pranav? Pranav is a naming word. This is the name of a person. And which is the describing word? Yes, tall. And then we have taken is also. And at the end we have used full stop to show that our sentence has been over. The building is tall. Which is the describing word here? Tall. I climbed the tall tree. On which tree? Yes, tall tree. Tall giraffe eat leaves from tall trees. Yes, tall giraffes eat leaves from tall trees. Yes, where have we used the describing word tall? Yes, most of time we have used the describing word before the naming word, like boy. What is this boy? It is also a naming word. Yes, here we have used it is after is. After is we have used the describing word tall tree. Here again we have used before the naming words. Again here before the naming words. So describing words, most of all we are using before the naming word. Either we are using it before the naming word or after is and are. So this how we have made our sentences.
Yes students, my next question is, can we use the same describing words to describe anything? Can we use the same
डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स टू डिस्क्राइब एनीथिंग मीन्स हम सेम डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स का किसी दूसरे थिंग को डिस्क्राइब करने के लिए यूज कर सकते हैं. जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. यस राइट. वी कैन यूज द सेम डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड टू डिस्क्राइब एनीथिंग. यस लाइक इन दिस सेंटेंस आई हैव यूज्ड हियर टॉल टू डिस्क्राइब द बॉय. दिस वर्ड टॉल आई कैन यूज फॉर अदर थिंग्स ऑल्सो. लाइक माई कबर्ड इज टॉल. माई कबर्ड इज वेरी टॉल. दिस हाउ वी कैन यूज. यस सो डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स आर यूज फॉर मैनी ऑफ द थिंग्स. एंड माई नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज what things can a describing word tell us about a place, person or things? Means which describing words we are using for a place, person and things. उसके बारे में हमें क्या बताते हैं जो डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड्स हम प्लेस पर्सन और थिंग्स के लिए यूज करते हैं वो हमें उनके बारे में क्या बताते हैं. जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन दिस इन द प्रीवियस क्लास ऑल्सो टू डिस्क्राइब द ट्रीज टू फाइंड आउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ट्रीज. जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. How did we describe the trees? Yes, we have compared the trees according to their shape, size and color. So describing words tell us about the shape, size, color, feeling and quality of a person, place, animal or thing. Like shapes, circle, square, yes, rectangle. These are the shapes. Color, red, green, blue, white, any color it can be. So describing words tell us about the naming words. Yes, these words tell us more information about the naming words. Yes, describing words tell us about the feelings also. And which feelings? Like happy, sad, angry. These are the feelings. And describing words we are using for age also, like young, old. And describing words we are using to tell about the quality also. Yes, quality can be, you can say that this boy is kind, cruel, honest, gentle. So these are the words which all are coming in the describing words. These words give us more information about the naming words. Yes, students, now it's time for higher order thinking question. Yes, think about the question and parents, please pause the video so that they can give their own answer. My question is, can you think about any describing words which we are using only for people and only for places? First you will tell me about the people. Which describing word we are using for people? Just now I have given you the answer. I have explained. Yes, right. Like happy, sad. Yes, you can say that this chair is happy. So this word we are not using for those things. This word we are using for people only. Yes, like we can say this boy is very happy. This boy is sad. Yes. And for places also. Which describing words you can use for places? Yes. Like this is a rainy area. We can say this thing that this is a rainy area. We can say this for a people, for a person. That this boy is raining. No. So these words we are using only for people and places. Yes, student, now it's time for application part. You will complete your S3 which is given on page number 43 in your workbook and it must be completed within 15 minutes. And how will you complete your worksheet? By using the words which you have used in S1 and S2. You will take the words from there and then you will complete your S3 and it must be completed within 15 minutes. Students, now open your workbook, page number 43. S3, describing a thing. Question number 1, write one sentence each about the mango tree and the pine tree using describing words. You will use the describing words from S2 and S1. In both the worksheet, you have made the word web. In those word web, you have written some words about the trees. So you will use those describing words to make sentences for these trees. Now question number 2. Write 3 sentences about the things that are the same between both the trees. Here you will write again 3 sentences. You will write here, you will take the words which are same for both the trees. Means you will take the similarity between the two trees and then you will write the sentences. Now question number 3. Draw a tree and write 2 words to describe your tree. Yes, students, what will be your today's homework? You will write three sentences to describe Pranav's garden. Means, what will you do? You will write three sentences to describe Pranav's garden. At last, we are moving for the summarization part. Okay, students, what have we learned today? Yes, we have learned to use the describing words to form sentences. By using the describing words, we have formed sentences. Like, I have written Pranav and these three words, by using the word I have written three describing words, and by using these describing words about Pranav, I have made the sentences. And I have used this with the naming word. First I have shown out the naming words, then I have taken SMR, which words will connect the sentence and it will complete the sentence, and then I have used the describing word, and at the end I have put the full stop. So this is how today we have used the describing words to form sentences, and we have achieved our aim successfully. I hope you have enjoyed today's class. Be ready for your next class also, and resources for next class only your content book, notebook and workbook. Thank you. Have a nice day.